Warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today we would like to talk about line of credit. So what is line of credit? Okay, line of credit actually is informal agreement. So it is informal agreement, okay, between borrower and bank, okay, about the maximum amount of credit. Okay, example is here. Okay, the loan officer indicate the financial manager that the bank regards as a the firm as being good to give the credit amount up to 80,000. So this is maximum amount of credit to the borrower during the forthcoming year. So in the next month, the financial manager signs promissory notes for 15,000 for 90 days. Okay, so this 15,000 we call it as taking down of the total line credit. The amount to be credited to the firm checking account at the bank. And before repayments of 15,000, so before the borrower paid 15,000 amount that they borrowed before, okay, they have additional amount to be borrowed up to 80,000, okay, minus 15, so they have another additional 65,000 to borrow. Okay, so this line of credit is no legal commitment on the part of the bank to provide the stated credit. So the stated credit here is not guaranteed. Okay, it's not guaranteed. Usually require the borrower maintain a minimum balance in the bank. So maintain minimum balance in the bank is compensating balance. So normally it's between 10 to 20% of the amount borrowed to be maintained in the bank account. Okay, the bank also require an annual clean up. Okay, annual clean up, which means that the borrower must have a loan balance of zero for a certain number of days in a year. So this is line of credit. Now we see the revolving credit agreement. So the difference here is revolving credit agreements, okay, a formal committed line of credit, okay, extended by a bank or other lending institution. So in this case, it is a guaranteed line of credit. So before that, okay, not guaranteed amount. So even though they have 80,000 the line of credit, but this 80,000 is not guaranteed. It's up to the sufficient amount from the bank. Okay, but for revolving credit agreement, so this is a guaranteed amount. So if there is a guaranteed amount, okay, the borrower have to pay a commitment fee. So normally commitment fee is 0.5% based on average unused of borrowing amount or unused credit amount. Okay, so it is more expensive because included commitment fee. Okay, so this revolving credit agreement is guaranteed amount stated. Okay, example here, during the past year, okay, ABA company borrowed an average 1.5 million. Okay, this is the amount borrowed under 2 million. So, this 2 million is guaranteed credit amount. So, as a result, they had to pay 0.5%. So, this will be commitment fee for unused balance. So how much is unused balance? Okay, guaranteed amount is 2 million. Okay, borrowed 1.5 million. So the unused balance is 0.5 million. So commitment fee times with the 0.5, you will get here 2,500 commitment fee. So based on the amount borrowed 1.5 million, the company has to pay interest. So how much the interest paid is 160,000 on 1.5 million borrowed amount. So what is the EAC? Effective annual cost is interest plus other costs. Okay, included here is commitment fee divided by amount received. So how much is interest? Interest is 160,000 plus commitment fee or other cost here is 2,500 divided by amount received. Amount received is the amount borrowed here, 1.5 million. So EAC will be 10.83%. Okay, thank you.